Hello, Brian. Welcome back to Ready, Set, Geek. Today, guys, we have the Audio-Technica AT2020 USB Plus microphone. It retails for around about £100. And as always, the link is in the video description below. In the box, you'll find the mic, the usual reading materials and warranty information, an old school USB cable more likely to be used with a printer than a microphone nowadays, a small tripod, a nice faux leather carry case complete with logo, and a mount to connect to said tripod or boom arm. I'm going to get the bad point out of the way first, as there only is one real negative. It's the tripod. The weight of the microphone and the size of the tripod do not work well together, and you don't need an engineering degree to see why. It's constantly on the edge of tipping over, and I'd highly recommend getting another stand or using a boom arm. Design wise, and it doesn't break the mold, the grey finish is peppered with these small black marks, which at first I thought was a sign of wear and tear. It's a curious design choice and won't be everyone's cup of tea, but after a while it really grew on me. The build quality is superb, the body and grill are all metal, and it really feels like a high quality product the second you get your hands on it. There's a small LED at the bottom of the grill when the microphone is powered on. Directly below the grill you'll find two dials. The left hand dial controls the microphone monitoring and your computer audio levels. You can decide how much of each input you want coming through to your headphones. The mic monitoring is latency free and worked well in my tests. The right hand dial is simply your headphone volume control. And on the back of the microphone you'll find a 3.5mm port for your headphones and a handy sign saying back, just in case it wasn't obvious. By now you're probably thinking, what on earth does the microphone sound like? Well, I've got a little audio test for you coming up now, but just to let you know, it's raw, I haven't edited it in any way, and it's also in an untreated room, so do keep that in mind. Hello everybody, I'm now using the Audio-Technica AT2020 USB Plus. I am about 5 to 10 centimetres away from the microphone. I'm going to move my head back just a little bit, so I'm now 15 to 20 centimetres away from the microphone, and now I'm going to move back to 30 centimetres away from the microphone. I'm now going to use a lot of P's. Peter Purchase Pickles, Peter Purchase Pickles. Next, I'm going to turn my head right 90 degrees and continue talking. After that, I'm going to turn my head left 90 degrees and continue talking. Hopefully that gives you an idea of what the Audio-Technica AT2020 USB Plus sounds like. I'm sure you can come to your own conclusions based on what you heard. For me, the audio is clear and almost studio quality, which for £100 was really surprising. I personally really liked how full, warm and professional I sounded. It has a wide pickup pattern, and you can see how when I move my head left from right, the audio wasn't too badly affected, which is great for sort of streamers who are moving about a lot, but this does mean that background noise could be an issue. It only has cardioid polar pickup pattern, which to be fair is the most common pattern anyway. It has a 44 kHz sample rate and a depth of 16-bit, which is in line with most of the microphones on the market. Overall, and you can't really go wrong here, the AT2020 USB Plus from Audio-Technica is streaming, voiceover, podcasting and budget friendly. It's simple to set up even for a complete beginner, it's plug and play, and with a little tinkering you'll be the star of the show in no time. The audio and build quality is far superior to most of its rivals at this price point, and the only real issue is that useless tripod. Better off getting a boom arm or a mic stand from someone else. If you want to make the purchase, the link as always is in the video description below. Otherwise, thank you for watching Ready, Set, Geek, and I will see you on the next video.